New data out of Mexico shows a large decline in the monarch butterfly population. Kaya Edwards joins us now with some highlights from this report and even some conservation efforts that we can try here at home. Hi, Kaya.
Hey, Rena. Monarchs migrating south from states like Minnesota are surveyed every winter starting in December when the butterflies are clustered together in Mexico. The new data shows their populations down almost 60% from last year.
More melancholy monarch news to report.
It's always hard to hear when the population declines.
Wendy Caldwell with Monarch Joint Venture published an article this week sharing the latest count from World Wildlife Fund Mexico.
The most consistent way that we have of measuring the population is at their overwintering sites in Mexico or along the coast of California, where the monarchs are clustered into this pretty small geographic region.
Eastern monarchs are those flying in from east of the Rocky Mountains. The report shows their population after landing in Mexico's fir forests this past winter was 59.3% smaller than the previous year. And it's the first time in a decade they've occupied less than 1 hectare of space.
Compared to the historic highs of around 18 or above 18 hectares, that's a pretty significant drop, given that the population was already lower than we'd like to see it.
Migratory monarchs are not protected under the U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service's Endangered Species Act, but they are candidates for it. And Wendy says they need support, as researchers believe severe drought conditions have affected their habitat.
Best thing we can do for monarchs is to plant habitat, and that's milkweed. That's the host plant, the only thing that monarch caterpillars can eat. We can put in our gardens or natural areas. The other important habitat consideration is wildflowers. Early spring all the way into the late fall as monarchs are migrating. We want to have continuous bloom throughout that time period.
In addition to planting, the Minnesota DNR says to minimize pesticide use and to participate in community science projects that keep track of monarchs. The DNR also advises against raising monarchs at home, even if you release them, because they say captive monarchs have poorer survival rates than wild ones. Rena?
A lot of great information there, Kaya. And boy, they're pretty to look at. Hope we can help them. Thanks. Yeah.